Hi all, welcome to Tech Forum. In this video, let us see some details on access management with MongoDB Atlas. MongoDB is a cross-platform document-oriented database program classified as a NoSQL database. MongoDB uses JSON-like documents with schema. MongoDB Atlas is the global cloud database service for modern application. So we will be able to deploy fully managed MongoDB across AWS, Azure or GCP cloud platforms. So the best in class automation and proven practices guarantees the availability, scalability and compliance with the most demanding the data security and privacy standards. So use MongoDB's robust ecosystem of drivers, integrations and tools to build faster and spend less time managing your database. So let us see how to manage the different access levels for the platform. So let me go into the cloud MongoDB Atlas configurations. So I have a sample database defined with the name test. So this is my cluster. I registered for a free, this is a free cluster. So I registered a cluster. Now if you go into the collections, yeah, you can see here is a database. You can add new database. I have a database with the name test. Here you can have multiple collections. So now I have a, maybe let me show the, yeah, here like database access. So my test database. So right now I created a user with the name admin. So it's having full access. So now I want to add a new user. So to provide the access. So okay, let me add a new user. So that user will have the access to to the database. So the new user can be authenticated through credential or certificate. So anyway, I'm going with the credential. So maybe we can see the details on authentication through certificate in another video. So let me add a new user. So here you can see password and certificate. Maybe for time being, I will ignore this certificate option. So going to the password, so I am just entering some user with the test user. Yeah, so I will enter the same password. Okay. So even you can auto-generate the secure password if you want. So then you like user like privileges, like you can add Atlas admin, read and write to any database, then read-only access. Even you can define a select custom role, maybe like let me show that first, the custom role. So you can go into the MongoDB roles, you can create a custom role. So here you can role name you can provide, then like any what is the action, like collection actions, database actions and roles, global actions and roles, anything you can select. Then you can select the database name, my case is test. Then like which collection it should be applicable. Then you can add that custom role. So once you have that role, so you will be able to look up that role here, like whenever you are adding the user. So anyway, I am going with the standard one now. So I will create a user. What I am going to do is that I am going to provide only read access to this database. Okay, now just add user. Okay, now the user is added. So so he will have like the user will have only the read only access. So right now let me maybe I let me try to connect to the database through this new user. So for that, what you can do is click on the cluster. So click on connect. Yeah, here multiple options are there. So connect with Mongo cell. So you can download the cell and you can follow that. So otherwise, other option is, so connect your application. From your application directly you can connect. There is multiple options, C, C++, Java, you can select the corresponding which application you want. Based on that, you will be able to copy this connection string, what connection string you need. Or if you want the full example, you can copy from here, this will provide the full Java code. So otherwise Node.js means you can select the Node.js and what version and all those things. Okay, for my case, I am going with maybe I already downloaded this Compass, MongoDB Compass. So if you go here, so you can select the corresponding this is the kind of client, database client, through which you can connect to the database. So you can select the database. So my case Windows 64-bit, I already downloaded. So then you can copy this the connection string. So I'm going to copy this. Yeah, so I copied this, so I already downloaded. So what I will do is I will go to this client. So here just you paste it, so new connection, so you can create it, then replace this username. So I have something like test user, my password also test user. Yep, done. Then you can click on connect. Yeah, so it's loading. Yeah, here all the databases are listed. So I'm going to connect to the test database. So that's fine. So here you can see the option called create collection. So maybe let me try to add a new collection. So I'm putting something like name test one. So I'm just click on test one. Yeah, you will see this message saying user is not allowed to do action create collection. So because this user is only having the read only access. So I will not able to create any collection. So I will go inside this test. So yeah, I'm able to see the collection inside the database. It's called again test. So the data is test one, test whatever, the JSON data. So I can try to maybe add data here. So it's a insert document. Maybe you can insert some JSON data again. So let me add some data here. Yeah, but I should not be able to insert this. Yeah, user is not allowed to do the action. So you can create create the required user and assign the required roles and access, so that he'll be able to perform this. Same case with by connecting with the applications. So next one is network access. So now the database access, you'll be able to create a user and provide the required access levels, and also you'll be able to define a custom role with the different access levels, and you can associate the same thing to user. The next one is the network access level. Let me go into the network access. So here you can see something like network access. So you will be able to enable the access from specific IP address. So means you can whitelist the required IP address. So only those whitelisted IP address will be able to connect to your database. So I have already whitelisted my local IP. If you see here, this is my local IP. So that is the reason. So I was able to access it. So but if you see here that whitelist, so the current IP, and also it will include the CIDR block. So with this range of IP address, so this will be the access will be allowed. So another thing, you can add additional IP address, whatever you want. So you can whitelist the IP address, individual IP address, or the CIDR block. So another one is you can allow the access from anywhere. So what does that mean is you can add, it will get added this default entry. So that it means anybody can access this database. Considering the security, this option is not recommended. So better to go with whitelisting the required IP address or the IP address ranges, the CIDR blocks. Okay, I already done my whitelisting my IP address. So I'm ignoring this stuff. So the next one is the project access management. So far we seen the database access and the network access. The next one is the project level access management. So we can provide the project access to individual users. Our team also can grant the access to API. So let me show you. See, always how this is organized is first level is the organization, all bins organizations, whatever. Then under that project, each project will have a cluster, then obviously the database. So now here the project, you can see something called access management. So you can get into that. This is the project level access. Like whatever, so far what we've seen is the database level access. So this is the project level access to, like you can get a project access to somebody else. So now what we do is like, so here you can you can add individual users or you can add a team. So also like you can grant access to the API. So like here one is the teams. So what you can do is if you want to add a teams, a new team, you can go into this arc one. So here you will see something called access. Yeah, you can see to go into the access. So here if you go into the manage, so you can create a new team here. From here also you can invite the user. So or you can create the API key. So you can perform all those activities from here. So you can click a create team. So you can put a team name, then you can search for like organization users by email address. You can add the required user into the team. So and then you can provide the required access to the team. Instead of providing the access to individual users, you can provide the access to the team. Okay, let me maybe go back into the project. Yeah, so access management. Yeah, let me maybe add a user here. You can click on grant access. So I can search with any user. I have another account. So yeah, you need to enter the full name. Yeah, you can select, it will search. Yes, my user is there, project read only. So you can say grant access. So when you grant the access, it will send a invite to the registered email. So then the user can go and accept. Once he accept, he'll have the defined access to the project, this specific project. Maybe let me go and see if I received the email. I should be okay. Yeah, I got an invitation from MongoDB Cloud. Yeah, so here you can accept. Click here to accept. Once you accept, so you will have the access to the project. The project, see, it's saying albins.org, this one on MongoDB Atlas. So project zero. So you are going to have only for that specific project, because we are giving the access to that project, specific project. Okay, the next one is like a team. You can if you want, you can give the access to team. So again, team, you can search with the team name maybe. So if I, something team, it will give you the team name, then you can add the grant access. So now that the last one is like maybe the API access. So this will have only, it will provide only the access to API. The previous two users and teams will provide the access to console, but this API key, whatever you are defining, it will give access to the API. So to connect to the API, you can use that API key. So now let me create a new API key. So note this public key, then enter something. Okay, maybe test. I'm going to give a project read-only access. So, but you can change the project level, what kind of permissions you require. You can make that, you can provide the project owner role or like a project cluster manager, any defined permissions you need, you can provide it. So, now I'm going with read-only. Click on next. Okay, copy this. So, so you're not able to get the same data again. So just to copy this and keep it for your reference. Okay, now this is fine. Now you can add whitelist entry, either single IP address or a CIDR. This API, specific to API, you need to whitelist the IP. So just click on whitelist. So use current IP address, or you can enter your IP address or the CIDR notation. So I'm going with the current IP address. So this is my IP address. I'm not adding any CIDR block. Okay, this is fine. Now done. Okay, this is ready. So now you need the two values here. One is this public key, another one is the private key. So whatever I copied already. So this is a sample, like maybe a command. Like what I'm doing is like I'm trying to access the database user details, because I have the read-only access. I like the admin provider the read-only access, so I will be able to view these details, data, how many database users are defined. So for that, like yeah, this is a simple curl command. So I am going with the public key, this one. Then this is my private key, so I'm just going to copy this and replace here. So another one is this value, this value. This is the group ID. So or it's a like a yeah, group ID. So that what from where you can get is they can go to yeah, project. Here you go into settings, you can get this project ID. Project ID is the group ID. So I already copied that, so I'm fine. Now I'm going and just executing this command. Okay. Yes, I got the response back. It says like there is a database with admin, then like all those whatever the detail, database user with the name admin, and another like database user, test user. So most of the operations you can even perform through API, but that required access level should be set, either read only or like whatever the access level like that API required. Okay, so far what we have seen is like database access, how we can grant the database access, then like network access, so whitelisting the IP address, then third one what we have seen is the project level access management, providing the access to different user. Okay, thanks all for watching the video, so see you in the next video.